What's up, guys? Brad here, aka Home Theater Gamer, and today's video is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to show you how I light my videos to get that cinematic look on a budget, so you can take your videos from looking like this to something like this. So one of the questions I get asked a lot is, Brad, you went to film school, how do I light my videos to make them look better and be more cinematic? Well, a lot of people think that running out and buying a brand new expensive camera will solve all their issues and automatically upgrade their image quality. But when they get home and start shooting videos, they're disappointed that their videos still look kind of amateurish and, well, just grainy and noisy. It's all about the lighting though. Lighting is the single most important thing you can do to your videos to boost the image quality. Even older cameras and cell phone cameras can see a huge boost in image quality just by lighting your videos correctly. I'll be throwing in some iPhone XR footage later on in the video so you can see what I'm talking about. Now, the lights I'm using aren't the best, but they are relatively inexpensive compared to cinema grade lights. So let's check those out right now. So here we are, I've switched to my iPhone, so I forgive the video quality, forgive the audio quality. It's gonna be a little different than what I'm normally recording onto, which you see my boom mic right there. And I also have the Canon M50 that I've upgraded to. I used to use a Canon T3i. Here we have the Neewer softbox kit. We have one here for the key light, which is lighting me when I sit right around here. And then we have another Neewer softbox that is pointing up to the ceiling, which gives me a nice little boost into overall brightness in my scene if I want it. The red light that you see over here, falling down over here normally, this is just the Neewer 160 light. I got a red filter on it right now. We got another Neewer 160 with a blue filter on it. And that's just giving me kind of an edge light on the side of my face. And then as we come over here, you'll see, I just have a simple can light with a blue LED floodlight in it from, I got from Lowe's. It was like $5 or something like that. That is pretty much it for the lighting that I have set up. Again, these are relatively inexpensive. The Neewer soft boxes, the kit was about $130. These guys right here are about, I want to say about $30. I did buy the AC adapter, so you don't need to use batteries, which is, you know, great. I'll leave the links in the description for this stuff below, so you guys can check it out if you want to. Oh, and before I forget, we have these little filter pack things that I bought from Amazon for the Neewer lights. They just slide right into place, as you can see here. They just come right out. It kind of makes it a little more diffused. You can add some colors and stuff. Again, links in the description. Check it out. So now we're going to start turning on some lights and trying to make things look better. Now currently I'm being lit by my ceiling fan light, which is a warm white light, not very pleasing on the skin tones. So we are gonna need to change our white balance because these lights are cooler. So we're gonna do that. We're also gonna lower our ISO in our camera. Currently I have it on auto ISO, which is something I never do, but it's sitting at about 5,000 ISO right now, which is really high, especially for the Canon M50, which doesn't really do well in low light. So we're gonna bring that down really low to about 100, 160, which means we're gonna have to brighten our lights a lot. So that's gonna make our image look much crispier with a lot less noise though, so keep that in mind. Now when I first turn them on, I'm not gonna add any color filters or anything. They're all gonna be relatively the same color. Why am I doing that? Because once we start adding color, you'll be able to better understand what kind of impact that has on your image, and will also kind of give you ideas of, hey, maybe I want to do this to separate myself from the background more. So with that said, let's get started. And to do that, first we have to turn off this main light.
Welcome to the dark side.
Sorry, I had to clear my throat there. So you can see now we're completely in the dark. And yeah, what else to say about the darkness? It's my old friend. But anyway, so we've turned the lights off. And now we're completely in the dark almost, except for the monitor lights behind us here. And so what I wanna do first is I wanna go ahead and bring my ISO down all the way to 160 here. So now, as you can see, we have the monitor back here. It's now not overexposed, so we can actually see what's going on back there. So now let me go ahead and turn on the main light, which is the key light here. All right, oh wow, look, it already looks so much better, doesn't it? Yeah, look, I'm looking at myself in the monitor. No, it doesn't look great. We need a white balance. So let me go ahead and do that real quick. All right, so we just white balance, and already you should start seeing that the image is a lot more pleasing. We have a nice soft light on me. It's casting this nice shadow. I got a little bit of a Rembrandt lighting going on, which is this triangle type thing. And now I'm gonna turn on my edge light, which is gonna help me separate me from the background. So there we go. Got the nice edge light here. We're lighting my the side of my head here. Now, if you have hair, this would actually look better, but I got this nice little hot spot here because of my baldness. It's great, isn't it? Now, this is a really simple setup. It's just two lights. It's the key light, which is the main light, and the edge light. And this is something that you could do just starting out. This doesn't look bad at all. And actually, it's very pleasing. It kind of separates you from the background and gives you a nice kind of depth to your image. But we can do better. So let me start turning on some more lights and we'll see what we can do. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the ambient light, which is this light facing in the upper corner over here. And we're gonna see how that looks. Should give us a little bit more light in our scene, in our area, so we can maybe see some more stuff in the background. Okay, that light's on. And so as you can see, it's kind of lit the background up a little bit. We got a little more detail. You could see all these boxes and pop figures and stuff over there, as well as over here off to this side. Now, we can do a little bit more. We're gonna light the background here in a second. But this, again, this is a very simple setup. You got three lights going. One's just kind of facing up into the ceiling, pointing into nothing. And it's just reflecting off the ceiling, just bouncing that light everywhere, making it look nice. So now we're gonna turn on some of the lights in the background and we're gonna start seeing a little more depth. But at the same time, these lights are all the same color. So keep that in mind. We're gonna adjust those in a bit to give us a little more depth and make it look a bit more cinematic. So I have this light over here, just kind of facing down onto these boxes. And you can see, I mean, because of our ISO and because of how low we are, it's just lighting these boxes, you know, a little bit, kind of giving us a little splash on the wall there, creating that depth. It's also kind of directional. You'll see in the upper corner, you see right here, it kind of gets bright. It's bright right here, and then it kind of falls off down here. I think it's just kind of a nice depth to the wall back there, just kind of, you know, giving it a little kick without making it overdone or anything like that. So we're going to go ahead and turn on the one behind the computer over here, and that's going to be our final light. And then we're going to start adjusting some of the colors of these lights. So all of my lights are on and they're relatively the same color temperature, except this one back here is a little more warmer. It's about 5,000 degrees Kelvin. And so what does that actually mean? So basically, the higher Kelvin, so say 5,600 Kelvin, which is what most of these lights are, is kind of cool. But as you move up, so say you get to 9,000, 9,300 Kelvin, that's very, very cool. Now, as you move down, so 3,000, 2,700 Kelvin, that's very, very warm. So we can actually use that to our advantage. And I'm gonna do something a little different. I don't normally light my videos like this. I used to. I like a little more color in my videos now. But you'll see, I'm gonna change this edge light to around 2,700, 3,000 Kelvin, and you're gonna be able to see immediately, it's gonna change kind of the light that's hitting my face. So I put that filter on the light, and I should mention that the camera is white balanced to 5,600 degrees Kelvin. That's kind of right in the middle, and all of the other lights are around that color temperature. So by putting this 3,000 Kelvin-ish filter on the light, we're getting that nice warm side light there, and it's already kind of giving us a nice little contrast, and that's what we really want to do. We want to create contrast within the image to give us more contrast. Kind of gives us that more cinematic look by creating that color contrast. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to return this light to where it was, and then we're going to work on separating ourselves from the background just by changing the background lights first. So I added a red filter to the light over here behind me to my right, and already we're seeing a nice separation between me and the background by just adjusting one light. And so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna actually change this light behind the computer to a blue. All right, so by changing that light to the blue, we now have this nice color contrast where we have red and blue just behind us, really separating us from the background. And now what I like to do is I'm gonna change my edge light over here kind of slightly behind me to also a blue color. As you can see, now with this side blue, it actually gives our brain the impression that this light behind the computer is actually lighting the side of my face. That's what they call motivated lighting. It's not technically motivated lighting because we can't actually see the light behind the computer. That would be like if we had a lamp on or something like that. So now we have some nice separation between me and the background. And one of the last little things that I like to do is I like to turn on some practical lights or some lights in the scene. So like I have this desk lamp back here. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on. And that just gives a nice little touch to the lighting. It accentuates whatever I got going on back here, like this filter that's just hanging out right here. We don't need that in the frame. And so now I'm gonna flip over to the iPhone and show you what that looks like with this lighting. So this is the iPhone XR using the Filmic Pro app at 1080p at 24 frames per second using an external mic. And as you can see, the image is pretty good. It is a cell phone. It's a little bit more noisy. It lacks that depth of field in the background. Now, just for reference, here is what it looked like before. That's a pretty big difference, if I say so myself. So back to the regular camera. And that's my lighting setup. That's how I light every one of my YouTube videos. Now, personally, I like a little more contrast in my image, so I normally might turn this light off, this one facing up into the ceiling over here. But again, it's all personal preference. The great thing about lighting is once you understand some core principles and concepts, you can just break the rules. Like, there's no set in stone rule that says you have to light something a certain way. If you like the way something looks, and it's very dark and moody, then go for that. It's all personal preference. Personally, for me, I like a nice contrasty image, and that's what I typically go for. So all personal preference. Have fun with it. That's what it's all about. And that's gonna wrap up this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you learned some things about lighting that you maybe didn't know, or maybe you just needed a refresher on. If you did enjoy it, feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below, hit that like button, and also consider subscribing. I do post new content every single week. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one where I try to get my $2.
$2.